Hello and welcome to Stormaster here, and this will be part 31. In the previous part, we managed to liberate Borlast and restore trade to it. And we actually, because I remember that I didn't have a trade post in Neverwinter, got one such established so I could trade with Borlast. Those routes up there are quite dangerous, and I don't know how well it will go, but if I had to go away from taking skills, I had to check skills for some reason. You can see we have 996 experience to go for level, which means we will be hitting level 12 quite relatively quickly. The Paladin, the monk, is going to be rather boring. The priest is going to be rather boring as well. But of course, I have stated that because of the monk, I will be taking craft Rondo's items on my wizard once he levels. And craft Rondo's items is essential basically because there's an awful lot of good stuff that you need to craft, especially the monk. He's depending very heavily on spiffy items, which are not armor and weapons, of course. And if we quickly have a look at some of the wondrous items, recipe things, if I can find it. Wondrous item recipe book. You don't need to. No, I didn't mean to examine it. I meant to open it. Open it. Hindwist, we have better than that. What have we got? Something useful. I forgot something useful. The Scabbard of Blessing, Gauntlets of Ogre Power. Just for as an example, the Gauntlet of Ogre Power, which will give 2 strength, 4 strength. Anyway, Chain Gloves and Emerald and 1 Adamantine. With the spell, both strength. Craft one this item, 2000 gold pieces. That's not so bad, but some of the other ones get a bit spicy. Insulate, headband of insulate plus 6, for instance. Let's see what I will require. A gold circlet, aventurine, 3 baldrial, which are some of the most expensive gems. Dispel fox cunning. Cast level 8, 16,000 gold pieces. I mean, plus 6 to a stat is quite a lot. But as you can see, this is not getting cheap. It's not going to be cheap. The problem is, I should most assuredly enchant my paladin's weapon predominantly, and I know exactly what enchant I want to get on it. But I'm not going to throw a very expensive enchant on a weapon I'm going to be replacing. I'm hoping to get hold of some adamantine, make an adamantine longsword plus 2, and then enchant it. But yeah, it's one of those catch-22s that you need to do something in order to be able to do something. You need to do the something you're trying to do, sort of thing. It's not a full catch-22, but yeah. Anything else? Do you want to say anything?
If there's anything you need, just let me know.
No. Okay. So we need to make a maybe we can go and speak to Volo and tell him about the wondrous places we have explored. Might be a good idea.
Hello again, friend. Good to see your face.
I've explored some interesting places.
Wonderful! I can always use more material for my book. Did your adventures take you around the Sword Coast or the distant lands of Samarak?
The Sword Coast.
Wonderful! Tell me everything. Omit no detail.
There's a cave full of orcs to the northeast of the keep, dangerous creatures eager for blood.
Unnerving. But a good thing to know of, should issues with such monsters persist. It shall be noted.
Never mind. I thought I had located more stuff, but apparently not. Anyway, we need to head out and about. We're not going to get anything done hanging around here, and I have a feeling we need to go back to Neverwinter in order to speak to the circle of friends. Because we have established the trade post in Neverwinter. Whenever we build trade posts in new cities, Jacobi will get a supply of stuff. That's how the Circle of Friends manages to sort the unlocks you unlock. There is a Circle of Friends merchant, but he just says, "Hi, I'm a merchant." Nothing else. So let's see what Jacobi has to say.
If there's anything you need, just let me know.
Show me what you have for sale. To see if there's anything interesting now. Arcane Archer? Arcane Scholar, basic dolls, strength, which is nice. There's also armor. We don't have any rope of monk over partners, have you? No? No, I didn't expect so. Hair shirt of Elmator. That sounds interesting. It's light armor, it's still armor. A robe is not armor. I was hoping for something like that, but there's a boots of tumbling, mage's battle robe. Well, could be useful. Yeah, most assuredly when we have some more money. But we haven't got any of that, of course. We need some stones of alarm at one point or another. You do not sell any kits. No, you don't. Poker. I think we are just going to head out the main gate.
Follow along.
I quite like this voice for the paladin, by the way. I think it's very, very paladin. By the way, the Circle of Friends mentioned. Fellas like you, we've made some of our most esoteric items available for sale, but you're not selling them yourself, even though you're calling yourself a merchant. What kind of merchant are you? A bad one? Yeah, something like that. Anyway, we need to make up our mind. And we will do that by going to the Devilland map and then hit the horse key, which is the spacebar in this game. Cool. And now we'll look at the map. We have done that. We have cleared Port Last. We have been up there. Been to Neverwinter City. We have been to Sundersy. Warp Cave we've cleared. High Cliff we've been to. There is the Shadow Cult. We have the Crypt we arrived in many episodes ago. And then, of course, we have the Leyland. I don't know whether to go down to the Shadow Cult. I mean, we need a bit of experience. But I sort of want to explore. You know what, for a bit of action, we haven't had that for a while. Let's go down to the Shadow Cult. See what we can deal with, do to deal with that, I think it's called. So, let us give control to our monk, because he moves significantly faster.
Your command.
And then moves on towards the Shadow Cult. I also need to work on some of those upgrades. You can likely imagine that getting portals going would be rather spiffy, but it's also rather obnoxious, because in order to repair the portals, our friend needs quite a lot of money. So there's nothing here. Wow. Anyway, let's just do a quick save and hope that's good enough. The crumbling ruin of an old fort sits here, but sounds within hint at reasons sinister activity. Enter the fort. Mwah! Spooky? Well, maybe not. Bound to be something half spooky here. It's also bound to be traps and all sorts of things. Whatever. That's what I meant to do. Oops. Shadow Mastiff. And some ghouls. You know what? Instead of just pissing about like you usually do, can you call some indoor lightning activity down on them, please? Sometimes we're able to go. Oh, Paladin's getting absolutely hammered at the moment. You couldn't heal him, could you? Instead of hitting... No, the monk is doing the work again. You're not going to heal anything when you're paralyzed. Yes, we'll all have to touch myself. And you can read that in any way you want. Very kind of them not to hit the cleric, which is crippled. Monk is really going to town. I'm so glad I got him. I mentioned that last time, but I will happily mention it again. If a monk is left to his own devices, he's a wrecking ball. You still don't want to heal my paladin, cleric?
Oh, yes.
No, you don't. Okay, you know what? Cure serious wounds, critical wounds, restoration, I might need that, so let's just... This is why I want healing kits, but I can't get them. So, anyway, you know what? In worst case, we will have to bash some locks. I don't particularly care about it. Ghoul claws, that's all we got from that. Okay. And there are several doors, and behind several doors are likely several monsters, so let us start where we can. We can open this door. It's probably trapped to high heaven and all that kind of stuff. Oh. Dire rats.
They will die by my hand.
He's just knocked down a rat. Do you feel heroic? Is he actually trying to turn undead against these guys and failing? I mean, the monk is quite happy to run around and kill stuff, so I'll happily let him do that. I should actually have my monk being the leader here, because I'm fairly sure there's some traps in this area, and my monk is the one with the biggest chance to actually survive a set of traps. That's fine now. A weapon rack. Tower shield. Tower shield plus 2, we cannot equip tower shields because that's fighters only. Bastard sword. Plus 1, we do not use a bastard sword. We may be bastards, but we are not using the swords related to them. So, the reason it's called a bastard sword, of course, is because it's considered to be a hand and a half sword. A sword you can use one-handed or two-handed. There's a trap. Can we avoid it? Likely not. Do you feel brave? That's an acid arrow trap. Yep. That's what I was afraid of.
What do you want?
These traps do not disappear. There's something on the other side of this door. Okay. There's a big fight in this place, and this could be behind that door. I can't remember. And if it is, it's not exactly children's friendly, whatever. One quick note later, I was right. This was the scary room, and I'm not keen on that. What can I do about it? What can I do about it? I can do something. I'm sure I can do something. What can I do? I can do some healing stuff, I think. Healer, heal yourself, or doctor, heal yourself, whatever you say. Okay. What we want to do is we want to go up here, so... Stop. Okay. A wise man now would disable control of the AI to make sure that all the characters are doing exactly what you want them to do.
Yes?
For instance, is fine enough with casting spells, it just tends to cast the wrong ones at the wrong time.
Yes.
Supposing hand, I storm. Did I forget to memorize the level? I probably did, because I'm an idiot, but I mean, there's nothing in that. Okay. Let us... For the moment, disable party AI. Get you over there, please. Trisha, you can go over there. Because we need to open that door and then throw a lot of crap in there. I'm going to quick save again because I can't be bothered to be doing this. If you don't like me quick saving this much, then there's nothing much I can do about it. Sorry.
Your command.
Go and open the door. Okay. As soon as you open the door, there's a warlock. You can attack him for the love of I don't know what. That warlock is dangerous. And now I just hope that you can do quite a few reflex saves because I'm going to be tossing crap in there right now. No, you don't need to walk there, please. Probably she does. You know what, we'll just have to... Okay. Hopefully the door is open enough now so she can do it. No. What about... No. You just go there. And then you cast the ice storm in there, please. For the love of... I don't know what. Are you more clever?
Press the attack, quickly!
Likely not, because the door hasn't opened yet, but... We will let it open, and then we will do this. And hopefully you will start smashing up that gate face. You will bless your weapon. And then you will start hunting people, and then we will enable the party AI and hope it does something useful. If the monk kills that warlock, that would be rather good. But someone kills him, I don't care. He's by far the most dangerous opponent in this place. The other spells are not particularly nice either, but the warlock, if people are not aware of the class, it is an incredibly one-sided class. But what it's good at, it's very good at doing damage. It's the only thing it does. Damage, damage, and more damage. Okay. My cleric. Oh, I forgot. These guys spawn. I hope she's healing herself. What's a monk doing? Can you try and get him to lie down? That might help. The shadow priest, the reason they die in such a dramatic fashion is the fact that they spawn greater shadows when they die, which is well, not fortunate. You didn't want to heal yourself, did you? But she's doing the shield of faith, I suppose, I mean, in melee when she's getting hit. Some usefulness to a certain point, maybe? I don't know. Don't die, maybe. How is that still alive? I don't know, but he is. Okay, that greater shadow is almost toast. You're not instead of just standing there looking like an idiot. I know you are one, but you don't have to be proud of it. Maybe you can cure yourself. That could be useful. Okay. Finch is there. There's a greater shadow here somewhere. Can we knock it down? I don't know. Likely not. It assisted her. Of course it did. Are you losing this fight, man? Can you knock him down, perhaps?
To your weapons, and don't let up. Attack!
Is that shadow we are fighting? Did it die? No, not yet. Okay. Hit this with a smite, Evil. Always good. As soon as it dies, it will spawn a shadow thing. So. And the drone updated, so we got the completion for this thing. Doesn't mean we're done, but... obviously we're not going to be told what heroes we are before we have fights of return. Which is always good. So, let's clean up this mess here. An amulet. Cool. Natural armor. Wow. Longsword plus 2. We're getting there. We're getting there, but it's not quite there yet. The problem is, of course, we could just go back out of the way we went in, but that's too easy. Mace plus 2.
This load.
Yeah.
A bit of a strain.
Period of wisdom plus 2. Was a full plate plus 2? What have you got? You've got a full plate plus 1. Okay. Let us see what we can do here. Yes. What have you got? You haven't got a necklace, you got one now. Because well, you need the armor class more
what do you want?
Than my cleric needs the extra wisdom. I'm sorry, but he will always get priority. Armor class has 23, we'll take that.
I believe so.
It's still overloaded thing, whatever. Longsword plus 2 is better than longsword plus 1, so let's equip that. The enchants only cost money. So, no, you're not hating me for that. Could you carry a chainmail by chance, mate? Thanks. Okay. So far, so good. So, cleared. We are now heroes of heroes and all that kind of stuff. As you know, all the good stuff. Are we looking for spells? Likely not good.
I fly where you will me.
Yes.
He's blown his entire arsenal. He's still got yes. some left. And what about... yes. What have you got? Well, you got some.
Well, now,
cool.
What do you want?
A million bucks. What I was going to say. We only got... yeah, we got 200 experience for that. But I'm sure we're about to get told how lovely hunky-dory we are. There's a skull case. Ludo. And some... nasty is here. This is not particularly good now, is it? What are you casting? You're casting shield. Okay. Once you've done doing that, could you do a missile zone kind of thing? Could you perhaps, maybe, there's only two of these guys here. Could you go over and help him, please? That'd be good. Could you help him? Unable to reach target, why? Oh, that's why. Can you help him? No, you cannot. Can you help him without one? Cool. Good. No. Okay. You should probably get that badly wounded first. Come on. Come on, kill it before it eats my wizard. It's a bit late for that, I think, unfortunately. Whopping 9 experience. They look like killing your characters, I'm just saying, by the way. They really have a certain enjoyment. They will keep hitting the your characters when they're down to make sure they don't get back up again. Which is, I mean, it makes a certain amount of sense, but it's incredibly frustrating that you have to use your coins of life in order to get them back up. It is not particularly friendly. Something I discovered, or I should perhaps mention, is that by and large the difficulty level of this expansion thing is significantly higher than anything else in the Winternights is thrown at you. There's a lot of really nilly fights, and you just think this is going to be a walk in the park, and then you get smashed. You know, one of those lucky quick saves where you just quick save out of a random consistency. And then you realize that the parcel you're going through is full of permanent fireball traps. Did I mention, by the way, that I didn't want to walk? Can you not walk through this? That would be good. You did. Anyway, we are done here. There's nothing in that room. There's just a passage filled with fireball traps. Nothing else. So we can either leave. We should probably head back to Crossroad Keep and be told what heroes we are and hopefully get the levels we need. Or the experience we need for the level. So. Just in case something happens, might want to rest out here somewhere. We can make a gamble. It could be a dangerous one, but let's gamble.
Your command.
You are the fastest one. You move. Of course, we got something to tell Bolo about. The monk is moving so much faster. I know I've said it before, but I like repeating myself, just like I like quicksaving. It is a fetish. I have a repeat myself fetish. Let's enter the courtyard. Some people like leather and whatever. I like repeating myself. And I must quick save. I absolutely must quick save. And go the wrong direction because, I mean, go figure. We got some items we can sell at least, which is always good. Honky honky donkey. Honky dory, I meant to say. But yeah. Open the door, please. Head inside and speak to Kelgar and say, "Hi, Kelgar. Hi, hero."
Hell's take those blasted bards. I always felt there was something shady about them.
Whether I'd thrown them out on their ear sooner, sir, I merely didn't want to overstep my bounds. Bones, wish I could have hired you instead. If you sound better than a half cloak, be a blessing. I still have the gauntlets. Some of the Great Cloak Pathfinder tracked them some distance to the northeast, but the trail went cold near the Neverwinter Woods. Wood, even. If the Anfis find out, I'll never hear the last of this. And even worse, I can't leave the keep to go hunt the damn thieves myself. For a group like that, they seem like they'd be boasting about their theft. Should make them easier to find. Good point. I only wish I could track them myself. See the smug looks wiped off their stupid faces. No asking for promises, since this is my problem, but I wouldn't turn down any help.
Yeah.
We dealt with the Shadow Priest. By the gods, I hope that's the last of them. I only regret I couldn't be there to thump their skulls alongside you. It's a good thing that some of the Sarnes people have sharp eyes, else those priests might have been up to no good for months before they got caught. So Sarnes people has been scouted? One of our other merchants brought the news to me at first, and my scouts confirmed it. No idea what a merchant was doing poking about in a ruin. But great luck to us, eh? How's it keep doing? Keeps going quite busy nowadays. All sorts have been coming and going. Cool. I will have to save the leveling for the next part, but the reference he's making in the original campaign, we Kilgar had an issue with his clan because he turned his back on his clan, basically, whether he likes it or not. If you confront him with the truth, he's not going to take it very kindly, but he wants to be a monk, which is not something common for dwarves, obviously, in this game at least. And in pursuit of his own hunt for glory, he abandoned his clan. And in order to prove that he was still worthy of the name Iron Fist, we found the gauntlets of Iron Fist, which are plus 4 strength and quite hefty gauntlets, but part of a set. And anyone who could lift the hammer of Iron Fist would be the ruler of Clan Iron Fist, which he turned down because he had better things to do, like ring around punching people in the face. But that's where those gauntlets come from. And they are a bit of a relic, and they've been stolen by some bots. But I will end this part here, and when I was contemplating whether to do the leveling in between, but may as well just level on recording. It's perfectly fine. I'll do that when we come back. So thanks for watching. Take care. See you next time. Bye-bye.